Hi guys, my name is Vivek and couple of people recently reached out to me that they were asked this question in their interview that what is the number of fact and dimension tables in your project? So I will be answering this particular question in this particular video. Guys, I have a quick request. If you have not subscribed to my channel already, please go ahead and do it now so that you get a notification as soon as I upload a new tutorial. Now I'm going to answer this particular question with the help of a retail organization example. If I'm giving an interview and somebody asks me this particular question, this is how I'm going to reply. Guys, we need to understand the psychology of interviewer. What exactly is he looking for when he asks this particular question? When he is asking this question, he is not looking for a firm number. Instead, he wants to understand if you have really worked on a data warehouse or you are cooking up a story. So in this particular question, I will pose as the guy who is being interviewed and I will try to answer this particular question with the help of a retail organization. So in my last project, I was working for a retail organization and this is the kind of data that we were capturing as a part of our fact tables. We were maintaining our order fact table where we were capturing the transactional data of all the orders that are being placed as a part of my organization. So the granularity of that particular table was my order ID. Guys, whenever we are talking about facts, this is one thing that they really want to know. They are not looking for a number that I had 5 facts in my organization or 10 facts in organization. They want to know the grain of those particular fact tables. That's the most important part. So in my retail organization, I had an order fact table where the grain was order ID. That means for every order that is being placed in my e-commerce website or my retail organization, I am capturing that particular order detail in my order table. It will have single row for each order. And the other important word is the kind of measures that you are capturing as a part of that particular fact table. So the KPIs or key performance indexes that we were capturing as a part of those order table was the amount of revenue generated as a part of that particular order, the profit made as a part of that particular order, and what is the delivery cost associated in order to ship that particular order to our customer. So this is the first transactional fact table that we were capturing in my organization. Then we were maintaining another table which was order item table. So as a part of a particular order, a customer can go ahead and buy 10 products. So here the grain of the table is individual items in order ID. So as I mentioned that as a part of a particular order, a customer can buy 1 product, 10 product or 100 product. We will have single row for each product of the order. So it will have more rows in comparison to my order table. And we will capture the same kind of KPI here as well. We will capture the amount of revenue generated as a part of that particular product sale. We are capturing the profit generated as a part of that particular product sale and the delivery cost associated with that particular order sale. So that kind of information, which was further lower grain than my order table, was being captured in order items table. And guys, at this point of time, I want to make a statement that I have worked on data marts where we only had 4 fact tables, 2 with the transactional data and 2 tables with the aggregated fact data. And I have worked on a system where we almost had 18 to 20 fact tables in my warehouse. It entirely depends upon the kind of information that you are capturing. And guys, your fact table is nothing but you are visualizing your data on different dimensions. For example, I can go ahead and create another fact table for my retail organization on the basis of products and date dimension. So here I'm going and creating a product fact table. Now the grain of this particular fact table, the granularity of this particular fact table is product plus date dimension. Now I can go ahead and capture daily sales of my different products, or I can capture monthly sale or quarterly sale or yearly sales. So I can have 4 fact tables created just by mixing these 2 dimensions. It entirely depends on my business requirement what kind of fact table I want to create. For example, as a part of my retail organization, I'm selling 100 products and I want to capture the revenue generated by each product on a daily basis. So in that case, the grain of my product fact table will be my product ID and my date ID. That means 100 products will have 1 row for every day. I will have 36,500 rows for an entire year, because we have 365 days. So for every day, I will have 100 rows corresponding to 100 products. And every day I will store these kind of key performance index. I will store the revenue generated by different products on a daily basis. If I want, as a part of my business requirement, I can go ahead and create another aggregated fact table on the top of that, where I will be capturing key performance index like monthly revenue generated by my products and that kind of stuff. So the kind of product tables that you have in your warehouse entirely depend upon your business requirement, what kind of dimensions you want to see together, and what kind of KPIs you want to visualize as a combination of those dimensions. That's how you actually go ahead and form your fact tables. So as of now, I mentioned three fact tables. I've mentioned orders tables, where I'm capturing the data on the grain order ID. Then I'm going a little further and I'm capturing the data on a lower grain. I'm capturing product sale corresponding to an order ID. It will have more rows. This fact table will have even more rows than my orders fact table. Then I'm capturing data corresponding to my product fact table, which will have 36,500 rows. So this particular fact table contains slightly aggregated data corresponding to my products. I can go ahead and further aggregate my data on a higher level. I can go ahead and aggregate this data on a monthly level. So when the interviewer is asking you this question, instead of giving him a firm number, you should go ahead and explain the kind of fact tables you had in your project. For example, I can go ahead and create another fact table which will be associated with my vendor's detail. So for example, I have 5 vendors who are selling these products on my e-commerce website. I can go ahead and combine this vendor dimension with my day dimension, and I can capture the important KPIs like the amount of sales done by these vendors, the amount of revenue generated by these vendors, the amount of commission taken by these vendors, and that kind of stuff. So here, if I'm taking my vendor dimension and my day dimension as my grain, in my aggregated fact tables, I will have 5 rows, one for each vendor on a daily basis. So for a monthly basis, I will have around 150 rows in this particular fact table. Guys, obviously I'm a little oversimplifying this stuff, but I want you to understand how you should go ahead and answer this particular question. I can go ahead and create my fact table on another dimension. So suppose I'm selling my products on 500 locations. I can take my location dimension along with my date dimension, and I can generate a fact table on the basis of that. In that case, I will have one row on a daily basis corresponding to a single location. Since I have 500 locations, that means 500 rows will be added on a daily basis to this particular location fact table. And the kind of KPI that this fact table will capture is the revenue generated by different locations, the number of orders that were placed for that particular location, the number of orders that were returned, the defective products. That kind of stuff can be captured as the KPI of this particular table. So again, it entirely depends on your business requirement. You can have a number of fact tables depending upon your business requirement. As I mentioned earlier, in one of the projects where I worked, we only had 4 fact tables, 2 with transactional data and 2 with aggregated data. In another warehouse where I worked, we almost had 18 to 20 fact tables, because in that particular project, the priority was to actually generate the reports very faster. That's why we already were storing the aggregated data on different levels so that the user can actually query the report very fast. Now let's talk about some of the dimension tables that were part of my project. Again, when the interviewer is asking this particular question, he is not looking for a firm number, but he wants to understand what kind of dimensions you had in your project. So since I am working for a retail organization, there are certain products that I'm selling. There are certain customers that are buying those products. So I will have a product dimension. I will have a customer dimension that will have the details of the customers who are buying the product, their date of birth, their city, their address, that kind of stuff, their phone number. Then I have certain vendors who are selling products on my website. I will have their details. Then the locations where I'm doing business. If I'm supplying my products only at 500 locations, I will have detail of all those locations. The employees that are working for my organization, I will have their details in one of my dimensions. I can go ahead and create another fact table using this particular dimension, employee and date. If I want to see the amount of orders that are being serviced by my employees, I can go ahead and create another fact tables using employee and date dimension. If I want to see it on a daily basis, I will use the day grain. If I want to see on a weekly basis, I will use week grain and that kind of stuff. If I want to actually promote 10% employees, or if I want to fire 10% employees, using this particular fact table, I can identify who are the employees who are servicing most of my orders and who are the employers who are servicing least of my orders. So if I have to go ahead and sack my 10% of the employees, I will identify the employees that have actually processed the minimum orders and I can cut them off. Another very important dimension that is common to almost every project is date dimension and time dimension. So I'm joining this date dimension with other dimensions in order to create my fact tables. And if I want to go further, I want to do it on an hourly basis, I can use time dimensions. So it will have 24 rows for a single day. My time dimension will have 24 rows for a single day. These are some of the dimensions in my retail organizations that I've used. Obviously, there are a lot of other dimensions, degenerate dimensions like order ID or junk dimensions that we can use. I'm not going to discuss them in detail right now. I have made separate videos on junk dimension and degenerate dimensions. You can go ahead and refer them. But I just want to give you a basic idea what kind of dimensions are being used in different projects. So as I said, that when interviewer is asking this question, he is not looking for exact numbers. Rather, he is looking for your grain of fact and dimension tables. What kind of information you are capturing in your fact and dimension table. You can actually go ahead and mix your dimension to create multiple fact table. For example, you can create a fact table using location, day and product. It will give you the revenue generated by products on locations on daily basis. If I want to run certain reports where I want to access my product sale data on the basis of location, I will go ahead and use this particular fact table. If I want to see the aggregated data on a higher level, instead of using day, I can go ahead and use month. Now the number of rows will be considerably reduced and the KPIs will be aggregated on the monthly level. So we will have less number of rows and aggregated data. I can go ahead and create another fact table using employee location and day as the grain of my table, or I can go ahead and create another fact table using employee, product and month. Idea is, guys, that it entirely depends upon your business requirement, what kind of data you want to fetch in your reports, what kind of analysis you want to do. And based on that, you will go ahead and configure your dimension and fact tables. So next time when the interviewer asks this question, instead of giving him a vague number, explain these tables, that these were the tables that were part of your fact tables. These were the tables that were part of your dimension tables, and they were created based on your business requirement, how the users wanted to see the data. Hopefully, guys, this answered your question. If you still have any doubts, please go ahead and drop in a comment and I will try to answer it as soon as possible. Thanks a lot, guys, for watching this particular video, and I'll see you in the next one.